Bobby H.
What it do, what it do, what it do. You know, just, you know, J.R. the Barber.
Marquita.
Paris.
Shanna.
So, y'all, we were supposed to have a guest, but I guess she chickened out today, so.
Did all that talking.
It ain't show up, so I guess it's just us today.
As usual.
As usual.
Gang.
Gang, we don't always show up, you know.
Check out those products in the front, though, y'all.
Locked or not.
Just check those out.
Dude brought her products.
But you know
what's crazy, though?
I've been waiting on these products for a long time.
Because she brought hers, but didn't tell us, hey, y'all, I'm bringing my products today. So y'all should bring y'all.
It's a surprise. It was a surprise.
Clearly.
I had to. You know.
Surprise.
Well, you can't blame her for your marketing mishaps.
Oh, let's get a hand clap. Yeah.
No.
Yeah.
Hold on, wait.
Hey,
no, I got something for you.
No. He can't even find it.
Hey, T.
Man, sit your dumb ass down.
Yeah, man. Like it or not, y'all see that. Go and purchase some wax, some growth
oil.
So
explain to us, what your products is, though.
So, the lock and wax.
That's
twisting
the one
wax.
In the bottle, right? Or that one?
The grease container.
Okay.
And the growth oil. It is really hair crack. Mm-hmm. Can I say crack?
Yeah, you can say whatever you want on here.
It's really hair crack, y'all. Please go purchase some of that. It's available for y'all.
I've been begging her for this.
I've been out of order.
I'm about to steal these.
So you don't got none?
I was slipping on my pimping for a little minute. But I'm back and I'm consistent, y'all. So the set is 32, 25 for the oil.
So it's new. It's new.
I've been had it out, but I've been like slipping on my pimping. Mm-hmm. But I'm back. It's gonna be consistent, y'all. So go and get it.
Okay, and what's the name of it again?
Growth oil and twisting wax. It's a lock and wax and a growth oil. The oil can be used for more than locks, though.
Hey, okay.
Yeah, check me out in this Milwaukee gear, too, though. Shout out, Jaden.
Yeah, I'm going to have to take your class, man. Buckle down to take your class because I really need to learn how to do dreads. For real.
Like, seriously.
It's hair crack.
I would just do short dreads. Motherfucker. I ain't gonna do long dreads. I would just do starter dreads.
Y'all, it's hair crack, though. Go and purchase it. I got it all on my page. The results, people testimonies. You know, it's really working. Trying to get it in the stores on the shelves. Consistency first. Well, how was y'all weekend?
The usual.
Like the sun up, the sundown. I got out yesterday though.
Are you? Where did you go?
I went to Skybox for a little second.
Thanks, Lonnie.
Oh, she said the class is worth it. Oh yeah, I know. She cold.
And
trust
she said
me,
the
I know.
Products are amazing. Thanks. Thank you.
Man, be doing dreads. He looking at him.
No. What?
Yeah.
He was looking at him crazy.
No, I said.
No, you said his arms too little.
niggas do dreads. It's see, I got the idea from this barber I follow that's in Atlanta, and he cold with them dreads. Like he cold. So
that'd be a good thing. Locks. Let's exit the dreads.
Okay. Locks. My bad.
You know, it's locks.
Like I had said, I want to learn how to do female hair.
Hell yeah.
It's just a hustle, bro. Everybody think, like, you got to be gay or something. You know what I'm saying? Like,
I used to think that too, though. Until I worked with a stylist that's a dude who actually, you know, he do hair and he's straight. I'm like, oh, damn,
you just can't be afraid to be yourself.
Yeah, he cold.
Worry about what other people be saying.
I learned that's from a man. People from doing things. A woman didn't teach me this. Like, I went to hair school, of course, to learn about, like, natural hair. But as far as the locks, they don't teach you that. A man taught me this, like, a long time ago.
They don't teach people. they don't teach you how to do locks in school, do they?
No, not at all. But it's tight.
That should be something that you should.
I got classes now, but I got to get bigger.
I'm saying, like, in a school.
Yeah, you know, somebody told me that. To start trying to be one of the people who come up in the school and teach about locks. I love to do that, though. I got to highlight some people. Because
locks is big. Like, locks is everywhere.
Look at you. Locks. Okay, you got it right. Yeah.
Right. Yeah.
I really think that's, remember I said I'm working with the Black Chamber of Commerce now. And, like, they've been helping me do a lot of stuff. It's, like, business-wise. They was talking about the, like a lot of businesses, we can get government contracts for what we do. So when they open hospitals, nursing homes, our schools and stuff like that, we can get big contracts to come in and teach.
Come on, Falcon. We got them classes available. That's dope, though. That's dope. That's big, especially for the Black community. So I got a question, though. Is tipping mandatory to y'all?
Tipping.
I mean...
No, it's not mandatory to me.
I don't.
Just because.
But it's always appreciated.
Oh, yeah, for sure. But with me, being that I'm already whacking anyway, you know what I'm saying? It's not like
a dollar barber.
It's not like a, you know, it's a mandatory thing with me. So, you know, I don't really be.
I feel. It's not mandatory, like, for the stylist. Like, you paying money for this service. We appreciate that. Tipping is always appreciated, too, but it's not mandatory. I feel like a waiter, a bartender, stuff like that, you have to tip. I feel like you should tip all the time.
Where do you... somebody
know? It's a website, lockitornot.com, or you can purchase them through me. Shoot me a message or something if you're in Milwaukee. But I got a website as well you can purchase the products from.
I like these questions you got on this
phone. Oh, snap. Let's go, P.
I'm over here. I'm like, let me see.
See, they saying it's not mandatory. Like, but you know, like I said, I feel like bartenders and waiters should be tipped all the time. Like, all the time. But in the hair industry, I ain't trying to shade nobody, but as far as hairstyling, you coming to pay me a certain amount, you ain't got to tip me. You know, I appreciate you for booking with me already.
So what's the difference then?
I don't know why I feel like that.
A bartender because a
bartender mostly
but they provide a service too, though.
But they mostly work off of tips.
Oh, okay.
You know, like you coming to pay me.
And a waitress and waiter, they get paid minimum wage. I think probably less than minimum wage. They really work off of tips.
So that's how they're making their money.
And as far as a stylist, like we have a set price.
Yeah.
So we gonna make our money regardless. We gonna make how much we wanna make regardless.
Right. Like if you coming in, you paying me this money to do your hair already, I would just appreciate you for booking with me. But see. She says styles can set their prices, bartenders can't. I just feel like
when
it's mandatory.
You do DoorDash,
mandatory.
Is it mandatory to tip?
If you're able to, yep. Because I
say DoorDashes, they be
no. The reason why I say that's why that's why I'm asking that because it's a dude I'm friends with who do DoorDash and he be pissed about motherfuckers who don't tip me.
I got something to say about that. Somebody had, first of all, it was real ghetto, but somebody wild just went crazy on Facebook about not being tipped because they had somebody that placed a really big order and they didn't tip. But I'm like, what if it was their last? All they had was that.
I saw that too.
Yeah, all they had was that, and then they wasn't able to tip you. I'm pretty sure you're getting paid from DoorDash already.
Facts.
If you able, what this person could have been ordering their kids, they last, you know, with their last. They ain't got enough money to tip you. They ain't got no car to get to the store, obviously. Like, dang, calm down. But they saying it's common courtesy if you provide quick and good service. It's common courtesy.
But like, as a stylist, like, say it's Monday. I don't work on Sundays and Mondays. If I get you in, or like, if it's a long day, it's 8 o'clock at night, and I've worked all day.
Mm-hmm.
you want me to get you in and I do you this favor of getting you in, I think it's common courtesy to tip.
Yeah. Especially if
I did you this favor. Yeah. I'm tired already.
Not on that aspect, I agree with you on that. Like, yeah, I definitely went out my way to, you know what I'm saying, to service you on my day off, on the day that I be chilling. So, yeah, a tip is mandatory.
You want to still be on the discount.
I'm telling you.
The light skin lady.
Some people do be wanting you to get up, come in on your off day, getting on your nerves, you know. Then don't tip you a red cent. Like, damn.
No, you know what I do for them people,
really
though?
Be off of your like, cause people just think, like, just because you just brought the food, then y'all don't come back, don't check, no nothing. We got to stop another waiter that's walking past, you know what I'm saying? I ain't going to say I'm not going to completely, like, but you don't get the tip that you was going to get if you was checking on this, you know what I'm saying, on the regular.
Chevy, you seem like the type that don't tip
me. I'm petty.
Chevy, you be being petty. Dog be in there on that.
But you can't say that, bro, because especially at the bar, anything in my life, I don't be giving out petty tips. My tips be like $5. Like, if I get a water, I still tip $3.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? Like,
yes,
that's love. What I do, too.
If I give you a $5, just keep it changed. Like,
yep,
you know,
yep. I get a Red Bull, $2. I give you a $10, just keep it.
From the club or something?
Yeah.
Oh, okay. I mean, I ain't trying to sound like that, but, you know, y'all men. I wish a man wouldn't tip me and I'm a bartender and I just poured your drink. Like, I'll be mad. You probably can't say nothing, but I'll be mad. Like, damn, you ain't going to tip me on what? That's bogus.
But you want to know why, though? With a lot of stuff, because it's a lot of females. Like, it was who was that? I ain't gonna say her name. I'm gonna tell you what you did. But she served me, right? And then I had at least like $13 coming back. Like, she just was like,
they automatically, they automatically tip themselves, they do be doing that, yeah, they do.
Take what you want, like, nigga, I could even give you the $3, like,
yeah, I agree with. Don't
just know just because you know I'm gonna tip you money, don't just take my chance. Like,
she made her own grip.
I got $50, bro. I got like $13 coming back, bro. I'm like, okay,
she had a good little tip. Oh, what?
She made her own gratuity. That girl, bring my change.
So
I walked off with everything.
Okay, so yeah, I just got a inbox from,
no, I ain't getting none this week.
From Asia.
I got a question for y'all.
I got an inbox from Asia. She said they found her cousin dead today. So
I'm sorry.
So that's the reason why she
condolences. Condolences. So,
sorry to hear that. And RIP the Bankhead.
Oh yeah, RIP the Bankhead. His funeral tomorrow too.
He was so young. That's crazy.
Man, that's crazy to die 17 days after your birthday.
And he was saying it too.
And he died 2 days before his baby mom's birthday.
Oh. Damn.
So that's some crazy shit, though.
Damn. I didn't know all that.
Man.
That's sad.
But like I said, I had saw the videos from his party at Vibe. He looked like he was checking out. Yeah, was about to check out because he wasn't like, you know what I'm saying? I'm like, oh damn, yeah, that shit fucking with
me. That's scary.
Like, his baby mama was posting like these little FaceTime pictures, like them last little couple days. Like,
he was checking, like, he was checking
that
out.
Shit. I'm like, damn, I'm talking about like,
yeah.
Or like, you can see like whole bone structure in his face type shit. Like, his face was skinny as hell. Like, she, like, he acting like he don't know certain stuff and all this. And all
that.
Like, so, it did really went like that. Like, you know what I'm saying? Like, that shit still going to your head.
And for you to basically plan your death to know, like, I got this amount of time left to live, that's a lot.
Fuck you up, like, to know, like, just to think, like, that should be like a countdown in your head.
Yeah.
Like, damn, the I ain't died today, you know what I'm saying? Like,
take people out.
For them to be,
it's the chemo that take people.
See, my grandma got that shit, but she not doing chemo. Like, she got a pill. Like,
how she doing?
My grandma, she do everything regular. That's why I ain't out here moping around. Yeah. Like, she still get up and do everything she been doing, cooking all that shit on the daily. So, like, it's not, you know what I'm saying? Like, hit me like, oh, like I lost my pops to that shit.
Mm.
Damn.
So, you know what I'm saying? Like, he had throat cancer, spread it to his stomach.
Mm.
But that shit, like, that shit was more, you know what I'm saying? Like, damn, Pop's fucked up. Like, I ain't want to go see him in the hospital, all that shit. Like, that shit really take a toll on everybody around you, though.
Right.
That's one of them situations where they got to keep sticking the camera down your throat into your stomach and stuff.
That's the biopsy and shit.
Damn. Like, so my granddad. He ain't died from cancer.
He did one, but he ain't want to do it again after he spread it because he beat the chemo and they put the trach in and shit. Like, yeah. I ain't hear my dad talk like the last 2 years before he died.
Damn.
Until his whole voice blocked.
Damn.
He had to be mute.
Like, man, my dad was walking around with a dry erase board.
Writing on there.
Writing everything you want to say to you.
And they R.I.P. the Bankhead, man. But,
yeah.
Fuck cancer. Damn. So I got a question.
What's up? What's up?
Is dating a woman who can't control her mouth when she's mad the same thing as dating a man who can't control his hands when he's mad?
Yeah.
That's not the same.
That is the same.
I'm saying it's the same thing, but that's not the same thing.
I mean, it's so not the same, but it's just... But
verbal and physical abuse is the same thing.
Hell no.
Verbal abuse is worse, if you ask me.
What?
Yeah.
So I call you fat right
the
now.
Words could
so
be.
So if I call you fat, I'm
saying I'm a...
I just want to do that.
I'm saying I'm a...
So I call you fat, your
words
right, compared to me.
Cut buddy. Deeper, fam. I'm trying to tell you.
Then you put
do.
Your...
Deeper, so
hell yeah.
Words can leave long-term psychological...
Facts.
And punch can, too.
It can, but...
You can.
I just think...
Anytime somebody raise their hand, then you're going to be...
Somebody said, yeah. I mean, I was going to say that you could be traumatized. And like,
exactly.
As soon as he raised his hand to reach for something, you jumping and balling up.
Yeah, that's true. That's true, too. That's, yeah. But verbal abuse, that shit
crazy. Raising your voice, bro, once you get to that... That, you know what I'm saying, that level of fighting and shit, like, you gotta think a person already waiting, like, mm-hmm. Oh, they yelling. Like, you know what I'm saying? Like, now nah, motherfucker already in defense mode, you know what I'm saying? Like,
Bible.
But yeah, no, I said, like, you know what I'm saying? It's similar, but it's never the same, bro. Like, that shit, like,
I mean, I think it give the same effect.
It don't.
Basically, is what I'm saying.
I mean, that's a common effect,
right?
But it's not gonna be the same, because then with the verbal, I mean, with the physical, you still gotta deal with body pains. All that shit, like, you know what I'm saying? Like, you ain't, they starting to get
anxiety. But when you heal up, though,
But then you'll never
heal up. The words is still there, though.
Bro. Do you know how bad anxieties is right now, bro?
No, I don't know.
Like, when people know about that shit, bro, yeah. I got a cousin, bro, can't go nowhere, bro.
For real?
A woman?
Yes.
Why you say that? She,
yeah.
She was abused a lot?
Yeah, but you know what I'm saying? Like, motherfuckers don't.
I mean,
too many people.
I ain't gonna lie. I would prefer like, to be physically
abused.
He said, "Hit me."
Just go and knock me out. Real quick.
I don't know though, cause I don't know, man. That's a lot to me. Like, a man can go in defense mode because this woman been tearing him down with her words, and the woman exactly. can go in defense mode because she'd have been getting beat on. So you move on to the next, and it's like.
You can't
die from verbal,
and I don't know. Both of them
hurt,
like
exactly.
Mm-hmm.
So,
but you can't die from
like,
verbal.
So it's back to what we said. That it's the same. It's the same.
But you can't die from verbal.
But
says
your
who?
Says
who?
You can die. From
you
verbal.
Can kill yourself.
I mean,
kill yourself.
I'm saying to somebody else.
Your ego could be bruised, and you could be fucked up.
So for me, just,
I mean.
If I just get to beat your ass nonstop, you gone.
He's speaking on a literal sense. That's what you speaking of.
That's what it is, though. That's what we talking about. She says it's the same thing, bro.
I got something for you. Hold on.
Somebody
hold
did
up.
Say.
You can't do that with me.
Somebody said verbal abuse sticks longer.
Hold on.
I don't know, man, because.
I don't know.
Listen, look.
Y'all think they the same?
I think verbal abuse lasts longer than physical abuse.
I personally think so. She kind of in between both of y'all. She said like, verbal abuse would make you kill yourself.
Exactly. I just said that.
But I'm saying though, you said what I'm saying, but like, nigga. I just beat the shit out of you.
What if somebody say something super hurtful and to make you get on their ass? Like, if you hit me, I'm hitting you back. And if I know I can't beat you up, I'm going to bust you in your shit with something. Nah, and kill you or something, you know? Because you hitting me. I mean, but what if a person getting damaged, they can't take them words, they do the same thing? I'm going to whoop her ass. She done said the wrong shit. So I don't know. Y'all funny as hell, dude.
That's why a lot of these rappers, they be like, my teacher said I wasn't gonna never be shit.
Exactly. And that stuck with that stuck with them though.
The motherfucker,
no,
bro.
That hurt them. That's why they putting it in their song.
That shit.
It stuck with them their whole life. Somebody told them they wasn't gonna be shit like
so you ain't never been told that?
Is the people, different people can handle things.
No, because I want a bad child.
But you can
tolerate mentally, child when I grow
the next person might not be that strong mentally.
Yeah, true. Because I ain't gonna lie. I can kind of tell. I done had moments where I done took stuff the wrong way. And then somebody else, you could say the same thing to the person next to me and they ain't take it how I took it.
Right.
So I agree with that.
Man. Words is powerful, man. I'm trying to tell you. No, a punch is powerful too, but.
So who made that lie up?
What?
Sticks and stones
may break your bones.
Words have never hurt. That's some bullshit. Yes, they do. Thompson, don't let the bed bugs bite. Not them back. Where the bed bugs come from? No, where they come from, for real, bro. They outdid the roaches. They outdid the roaches, bro. Remember roaches? Like, where the fuck did the bed bugs come from?
Roaches.
But bed bugs have been around for a long time, like before our time. I can't tell you the year.
Not in the black community, though.
No, long before.
I think that I ain't gonna.
They went away. Well, this is what I don't understand: how things go away and come back. Like y'all in the lab playing with these things.
Nasty people.
Y'all think they just dropped them down on
but
them?
But if they're gone.
But you can't say
they just
no. You can't say
regenerate from nothing.
Shit still lay eggs.
But you can't say
but they're all gone.
But you can't say nasty people though.
I'm saying
because bed bugs have been in hospitals, they've been in movie theaters, they've been in cars. So
they're getting transported.
You rather have roaches or bed bugs? You rather have roaches or bed bugs?
Roaches for sure.
See,
hell yeah,
roaches don't fuck with you. The bed bugs don't fuck with you. For real. Roaches don't fuck with you.
Roaches don't fuck with you, though.
I'd rather have a roach.
All right.
Exactly.
You probably look at me in there itching and shit.
He killed one.
Bed bugs.
You would have bites.
Swear to God. Roaches don't fuck with you. Yes, they do. Bed bugs is hard. Bed bugs is hard to get rid of, fam.
You can get rid of roaches.
No, I haven't, but
I think it's the same infestation.
You can give me a couple mice in the crib before roaches and bed bugs.
Mickey Mouse can stay home. Mickey Mouse can stay his ass at home.
No, I'd rather have roaches than mice.
I'm cool too. I'm scared of them. I had a choice. If I had to make a choice, I'm going with the mice, bro.
Roaches gonna be damn. They gonna come out with the lights off
at nighttime.
Yeah,
at nighttime.
Roaches always come back.
No,
y'all better not have no roaches in 2023.
Bed bugs worse.
But you can get a service to get rid of bed bugs.
You can get bombs.
But you got to get rid of all your shit too.
Yeah.
Damn it, all your shit. You got to get rid of
bed bugs. You do.
They come in and heat your shit up to a high. They just die.
So you still gonna have that shit in your couches and shit?
They roaches could survive a nuclear
bomb.
These motherfuckers don't die.
Roaches stay around forever.
Y'all better not have.
You though. It could be a roach on the wall right now. He's not gonna bother.
Not gonna
none of us in here. A bed bug.
See, I'm cool.
That's too bad. You know what I'm saying? Seen
I feel like you can get rid of mice faster. I'm talking about from back in the days, y'all. It's too much stuff to get rid of this stuff now. So
yeah.
Back in, a couple mice in the crib. You just keep the catching the, you know, make sure they don't have no babies, get rid of them. You can get rid of them
but
quick.
They just so
but now you can't pay me. I don't play. I've been a movie. Don't even play with me.
I want to read one of your questions.
Read it.
Okay, this Marquita question.
Oh, what you reading? So it's your question. No, that's her question.
Man, just read the question.
Okay, her question is, this is my queen of question, y'all. Do you think it's okay for your girl to dance on her favorite R&B singer on stage?
Hell no.
Why, though?
No, why?
So like, what if you...
If it was the other way around, though, y'all wouldn't even look like
you would do it, though.
What do y'all say?
Men is... Your favorite female singer is performing on somebody stay funny, but your favorite female singer performing on stage and she call you up there to get you a dance or something.
You're not going
just
up
out of respect. No, I'm not going up there. I'm not. Now, if I was by myself, now if I was by myself, oh yeah, I'm going up there for sure. Right. For sure. Oh,
if we together,
but if I'm with her, that's disrespectful. I'm leaving you. I'm leaving.
I don't believe it.
As soon as you go on, as soon as you go up there, I'm going to the nearest exit. It's not just a dance.
After party.
That's why he did it. The vision was performing on stage, and this chick, he caught a couple females on stage, and once she didn't even, the dancing was harmless, like she wasn't even doing too much.
She was single though.
So one she went publicly and said she was single. So this one dude got to trying to drag her. Oh, you had fun talking crazy. And she like, I'm single. So Division like, hey, she needs some higher vibrations. I'm finna, he bought her some flowers, did all type of extra shit. But it was because dude was being a lame, trying to tear her down, and you weren't even her man. So that's the only reason
I mean, that's different. Yeah, that's.
But y'all don't remember when Beyonce and Destiny Child, when Destiny Child did that Cater to You performance with Magic Johnson, Nelly, and Terrence Howard. So if one of them would have pulled y'all on stage, y'all wouldn't have sat there. Magic Johnson was married.
If I'm with my girl, if I'm with my girl, no, I'm not going up there just out of respect. But if I'm by myself, I'm going up there for sure. For sure,
I'm going up there for sure. It's the same, but it's not the same. Everything is
double standard.
Everything is recorded and put on the internet.
Harmless dancing.
No, not back then.
Everybody gonna be like, yeah, back then it wasn't no internet like that.
You seen the shit that's been going on,
and that's why I gotta leave her.
The shit that go on at that shit does not be harmless, fam. Chris Brown and then caught a case.
Yeah, that's some growth oil and locking wax. See, he said he going.
We know you going.
Yeah, that's dead. We know he going.
Y'all ever caught your parents doing the do?
As soon as they get to play that old skew music at nighttime, you already know.
My daddy walked out the room and gave me the phone, bro.
He ain't cover up with that?
No, bro.
That's so
weird. Not my mama.
Why you gotta say a white lady?
So you feel like it don't matter if it's your dad, but if it's your dad and your mama, it's a problem. Or if it's your mama and her boyfriend.
Both of them. I want to see that shit. I want to see neither one of them.
Exactly, Terry.
What?
Y'all be tripping, man.
No, I'm not, because it's gonna be an argument when you leave. Oh, you was enjoying that shit too much.
See, that be
No.
What? That should be a test.
You're going too far.
Okay, what's the difference between going to a strip club?
That should be a test.
So y'all don't go, y'all wouldn't mess with a strip club.
Then. Now that is different. Now that's
he said it's a
different
because that's something right.
When
you get your money, you give it to your girl so she can tip. You just sit there.
I ain't gonna lie, I'll be traumatized for life.
But yeah, but going Right, that's what I said. Trust me, it's not the same.
I would rather my nigga be dancing with Beyonce, letting Beyonce twerk on him than
you ain't. Why? You not finna see Beyonce again? You ain't finna stick your hand in her ass? What? It's
especially if you out of town.
You can pay this girl for sex.
If you out of town.
You can pay her out of town for sex. You can pay this bitch to bust her down.
Both of us, yeah.
No, no. You can get her number on the low.
What if your girl is not there?
Huh?
Then everything goes.
I don't go to strip club.
JR, you want to be innocent so bad. I feel you.
Innocent.
Your girl be tuned in. Ain't no problems at home. I feel
I am
you.
Innocent.
Man. Exactly, T. You could definitely pay this girl or you can get it for free.
Nigga like me gonna try to hit Beyonce too.
You can go link up with her in the club on a regular club. You can see her. Y'all can give each other a number.
Out of town.
Beyonce performing.
If you're out of town and you're at a strip club.
Bro, out of town strippers, really?
I'm not going to go to a strip club here. Hell no.
What? You ain't going to tip our strippers?
No.
Our scripples?
No. That's a whole nother topic. Hell no.
You be at all
these.
I be at, and I don't be tipping.
Y'all ain't finna be shading our city. We got some bad bitches here.
They'll tell you all that. That nigga JR. They'll tell you. Oh yeah, I ain't going there.
I ain't even gonna lie to y'all. Like, I know some people who be like,
why is that though?
Why do men? Some men think that it ain't just y'all. I heard that. Cause
they thirsty as hell, bro.
This they job.
And all strippers are a different. See you getting changed? Like, as soon as you turn around,
the strippers
you train.
Like, listen,
but they train for that.
Wait.
What?
No shade. The dancers here are a different breed. That's all I'm gonna say.
What you mean by that?
It's some that's smooth, but it'd be like the younger ones, friend. They be too drunk. They walk around barefoot. They in there. Wigs.
See, look. I told you.
No, you finna put your shoes on.
I told you. That nigga don't tip at all. I don't know.
They just be, you know what I'm saying, out of town. That shit different, bro. Like that shit completely
see,
different.
I
don't know. I'm a woman and I've been to strip clubs in town, out of town, all of it. And strippers is strippers. Like, listen, some of the strippers, I ain't gonna lie, you train to watch the time machine and watch the man who throwing the money. That's what you got. Your job is to get some money.
Strippers here are more thirsty, man, than dancers out of town. I'm telling you, I done been to Atlanta. I done been to strip clubs in Florida. I done been to a strip club in Houston. I done been to a strip club in Arizona. The dancers here are thirsty. That's just
them hoes out of town was thirsty from what I seen too. Shit.
I thought that's what strippers and them, are supposed to do.
That's what I'm saying.
Be thirsty?
It'd be cool,
no.
But it's a whole nother level of thirsty.
Let me walk in and get a drink first and chills and peep the scene. Like as soon as I walk in, like what up, JR? I'm finna go. Like, no, I changed my mind.
I want to tip the bitch I like. Like, what you mean?
Yeah, that one stripper was out here.
What? Motherfucker grabbed me like.
As soon as he walked through the door, bro.
She hustling.
Yo, I walked up. She's sitting down at the bar behind me. Like, you ready? Like, no.
She hustling. I ain't gonna lie, I got a tour with my dude at the strip club before, but it wasn't because of him. I feel bad to say this.
He looks like a sucker.
Bro, I got so loose in the strip club.
Did you? Yes.
He like, don't you think you have too much fun? I'm like, I ain't realize how wild I got to get in the strip club.
I love to see my girl having fun in the strip club.
They looked up. I was off the section. I'm at the stage. I'm over here surrounded by strippers. I'm partying, going crazy. He came over there like, don't you think you having too much fun? Like, no, it's cracking in here. Right. I like this. So, I don't think I could really go to strip clubs like that. I be getting a little too wild. Not in Milwaukee, though, because some of y'all need to retire. Ain't you supposed to get in and out? That ass tied. Like, we'd be like, come on, man.
Got a dent in the middle.
I was seeing strippers. They've been dancing. Some of them, I was 19. I'm 30. They still in the
still
game.
Still dancing, yep.
Tied. Can't even move out of breath. Like, still come on, man. Go bartend. Do something.
They got one signature move.
Must not be enough money going around.
Shit.
Y'all funny as hell. Don't do them scripples. They just hustling, though. I'm telling you.
I respect the hustle for sure.
If I got to get some, you got to.
I ain't supporting it.
That's what I'm saying, Terica.
I love the host, though. Yeah. I ain't gonna lie.
I respect it, but I'm not supporting it.
Wait, what you mean, though?
I support it in a way like, okay, let's just say I know a dude who need a couple dancers.
That's
okay,
different.
Then I'm a bam, yeah, bam, you know what I'm saying? But as far as like,
don't my body?
Nah. Nah.
For free?
Nah.
Loosen up.
For free? Nah.
Get that change and throw them ones.
I got my girl dance on me for that shit. We can throw that shit around in the house, dog.
You throw it around in the crib.
But it ain't like a...
That can be your little sex, little, you know what I'm saying? Baby, you gonna be a stripper tonight, you know what I mean?
Y'all but, can role play, yeah. Y'all can role play, yeah. Definitely.
Man, go to that strip club and have fun.
I do.
You
out
go
in
here and fill on some ass, out throw some ones, and get
I
loose.
Do, out of town. I
you
do.
You want to do that?
So you just don't like them here.
Yeah. All the yeah.
Everybody know all the strippers.
I didn't know what you school with them, all that shit. Like, you be like.
But y'all popular
so
people,
you're
though.
You have to go out of town and see some strippers.
Y'all ain't yes. fair, man.
That might be why, too. Yes. I don't like them because I know them.
Yeah, y'all popular
yeah,
people.
That might be why.
Out of town, them hoes be known, too, for they.
Yeah, you right. I swear to God, you right. Yeah, swear to God, right, they do like know too.
Yeah.
Out of town.
Y'all is not right, dude. That ain't right.
No, I respect the hustle, though, for sure. I
but why do y'all go, though? To
I don't go.
Because she said, why y'all be there if y'all ain't tipping?
See, I go to the events.
It's still a bar.
It's a difference because I'm going.
You it's still a bar.
Because it's still a bar, y'all.
You could have went to a regular bar.
Bars are bars. They're not strip clubs.
Hey, I ain't going to lie. I'm tired of that. Sometimes when
everywhere
we want to...
Everywhere we go, there's
strippers. Yeah. Milwaukee do be forcing it with
Monday
that.
Monday through Sunday.
Like, damn, why are the strippers literally, up in here? Like, I done left them.
Everywhere we go, there's strippers.
It was just some dancers at Hex last night, wasn't it?
Oh,
they
shit.
They
going to maintain.
We already said that.
Here go
we
maintain.
Said that already.
Oh,
nigga, we
shit.
Said that.
Here go maintain, man. He said a swift 50.
I'm throwing a swift 50.
Down to ones, right? All the hoes get $5.
Them niggas.
Here go maintain.
Everybody else said, duh, we just said that, maintain.
Maintain, you got to go back. You can call them.
What'd you go back for? What'd you go out for? You gonna call around like where everybody at?
Oh, you talking about what maintain said?
Yeah.
No, it wasn't no danger.
I told him that. It wasn't no danger.
Fam. Nigga, you on the late show, boss.
Y'all
throwing money because we here he go. Hey man, we for the block, man.
But
hey,
that's
man.
The stripper's job. Like what? My money, not me. I'm just saying for they on their point of view. My job is to come in here and shake my ass for money.
That's a fact. Yeah.
Tip me.
Maintain said they throwing money because they got it. We
have no money problem. No, maintain that ain't true because I know niggas with a lot of money and they don't tip strippers. They just don't like it. That's not yeah. true. It ain't about being broke or not. It just I don't know why they do that.
Everybody I don't know. All men don't like strippers like that.
Oh, he's saying it's stinking there.
They
do be a little stinky.
Hey, little pool be off, babe. Bye.
They little pool, really?
No, it can't. Come on, they is adults. Ain't no way.
They be musty too.
What? See, this too much for me.
I ain't gonna lie, they call some a little tart. I ain't gonna lie. Yeah. I swear to
not
God.
In that strip club, and you can go in the back and yeah, wash your. You...
Now where?
Oh, come on, y'all. I be trying to take up for y'all, give y'all the benefit of the doubt. Y'all, we put y'all for
right, bro.
Job.
That's exactly what we said,
we
though.
Said that
like, that's their job, but it ain't their job to chase us for that money, though. Like, damn, as soon as you they see you, even
that shit really be a turn off.
I can be getting changed to go
I'm
pay for my damn party.
That shit be a turn off.
You
know what I'm
saying? Train to watch the time. That's how you hustle.
To be like,
you train to watch the ATM. You train to watch the nigga who throwing the most money. You train to notice that stuff so you can get some money. That's a part of you hustling.
Yeah,
that's
but it's when you're too thirsty with it, though.
Oh, okay.
It's a thirst
Shannon
level.
Ain't letting that go.
No, it's a thirst level with that shit.
Right, it's supposed to be what some like seduction going on first.
Why y'all be taking? Why y'all
get in your pockets?
Why they be taking their shoes off and shit? Like, put your shoes on. You look a mess.
I hate that.
And then another thing I hate too is when they dancing and they get on their head with their hair like.
Wait, they what? Doing hands. They doing the move.
You need to be doing that shit on top of religion.
So you gonna put your hair
floor be solid wet though? Like niggas and drop
on the floor.
I mean, I'm a female.
That we just walked in.
Oh,
with, like
I'm thinking you talking about like on.
No, I'm talking about the dancing. Not the dance. I'm just talking about, you know what I'm saying, when chicks be dancing in general. No, I don't like, like, nah. Get your head up off the floor.
Man, funny. It's funny hearing this.
I used to dance.
Right. I told you I had a person like latch on to me.
He ain't letting her go. For real. He's not letting that go.
He did. He did for real. He did.
As soon as we walked in there, I got the singles. I put them in my pocket. I'm trying to roll up.
She was hairy, scared.
She was already on me. Like,
but that's probably somebody.
And she said, you can't tip nobody.
They probably like that.
Oh, yeah. No. Nah. See, she doing too much.
The girl in the green, fine.
That's my cousin. Oh. Look at you gonna get all messy. Thanks, cuz. Listen, that's crazy that y'all say that because I'm a woman. So when I get to the strip club,
the stripper.
No, he. What? You ain't no way.
No, for real. Like,
hey, is Mac Tyson still on here? The stripper from KOD's when we was in Miami, bro. This bitch was from Southside, Georgia. She's from Chicago.
Hey, look. He says Susie Kane is doing it. Yeah, they be like that for real.
But these strippers nowadays be lazy. They don't be hitting the pole like that. Like, girl, I'm a woman. It ain't enough of them for me to
just twerk. That's it.
But I'm a woman. I need to see some tricks. Spin on the pole or walk on water or ceiling or something.
You're a human box,
oh my God.
Yeah, I hate that. Like, but. Why are you on your head on this floor, though?
On the nasty.
On the nasty floor.
They trying to put a show on.
Nah.
Look,
she, yeah.
Me. I mean, I hate when girls be in a regular club rolling on the floor. Like, you, this, what, come on now. Get up.
That's what they latching on to you for. That's your ass
don't tip. Taking your shoes off.
Taking your sit my drink.
Shannon, you need to get out of there, man.
It's a bar.
Dude.
It's a bar.
How y'all feel about polygamy?
It works for some people. For most people, I think it don't work, though.
Why do you think that is?
I think people got the wrong idea about polygamy.
Wasn't you in a polygamy situation?
I had a lot of bitches.
You sure?
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Oh, okay. Because the way it was told.
No, you can't type my name in no dirty hoes.
Okay.
Little filthy rats.
You can't even satisfy one woman. Like, you ain't doing good at taking care of one household. I mean, a household with one woman. How you finna have two and three?
I agree.
Y'all talking about this nigga maintain
so messy. He talking about that stripper.
No, she ain't a stripper.
Nope, maintain.
He said a little bit.
He talking about me. I said, I'm asking a question. Don't be tying me to no dirty holes now. I said what I said. I asked the question. How y'all feel about polygamy? Maintain, how do y'all feel about polygamy? Y'all want to be bringing back the dirty holes and shit. Come on now.
I think if everybody is on the same page, it could be a good thing.
Go ahead. Two men and
what?
And a woman.
Come on. Wait. I got something.
Hit her with that one.
Mess your dumb ass down.
two men and a woman or three. It's this girl. Oh, what? You showed me that girl. I see three men.
No, it's.
And it's one. It's just it's a girl and with, three men, with
two men.
Three husbands.
And her. But the two men is gay.
Man, tell you funny.
No, so they bisexual.
So they gonna always be gay, y'all think.
But that ain't true though. Like, so
women, they gonna always be gay too, huh?
See a straight man that's in that, and it's another man involved, and he's not gay.
No,
that's impossible.
Let me explain it different.
Please explain it.
So how you saying this sounding this? I get what you saying. No, but how many times? Not y'all. Specifically, but I'm saying men. How many times y'all heard a man say, or he try to talk to a chick and she be like, I got a man. So what they got to do with me? You okay with it anyway? You just ain't putting a certain label on it.
That's not what that
bro,
means.
Bro, yes. Come on, listen. Bro,
quit. Hold on, wait,
if you okay.
Hold on, wait. Hey, shut up.
I ain't finished explaining it, though. But you got to let me explain it.
Your dumb ass.
No, I ain't talking about two men. I ain't talking about two men and a woman having a threesome. I'm not going that far. I'm saying, I done heard so many men say, what they got to do with me? Like, niggas will sit back and play that side role. So
that's different. That's not
if you openly know. No, polygamy doesn't always have to be sexual. That's what I'm trying to explain. No, but I'm just saying men act like it's a problem.
Okay, educators do.
No,
educators.
I'm saying men be acting like it's a problem.
She definitely the pro.
Hey.
I don't understand how.
What I'm trying to say is.
That's all
y'all
beautiful.
In the relationship.
What was the point of you getting so that?
It's not really that. Hold on, let me
it's not really, I'm not really saying that. Like, polygamy doesn't always have to be sex, you know? Like,
but sex is involved, though.
You, what I'm trying to say is, people be okay with shit and don't even be realizing it. Mm. So, you can be like a man, you could use me for example. It ain't, you know, I ain't saying it's accurate, but you could be like trying to talk to me and I like, I got a man. So, what that got to do with me? You don't give a fuck about that. But y'all sitting back acting like y'all care about this girl talking to this nigga. Y'all don't give a fuck about that. So at the end of the day, you just live life. I'm not saying polygamy has to be sexual. It don't.
But isn't that the purpose? It's supposed to be a relationship, though.
But y'all keep tying polygamy to threesomes. That's not what it is.
It is, though.
It's not. You got to look up and look into polygamy. It's not always sexual.
I'm not saying yeah, that ain't
just
like.
It's just a part of it. It's like it's just a part of any one man and one woman relationship.
The whole thing is for it to be a relationship, right? That's so everybody can come as one, right?
On my behalf.
So if y'all not in the same household, then that's just you having a side bitch.
No.
They
having a side bitch.
Bro, I'm just saying.
Whoever, a side individual.
Whoever, if it's the male or the female.
So, is it?
That's just you being okay with the side female.
No, that's a train. That's not a three.
No, so.
That's a train.
How many niggas you know would be like, I done heard niggas go, I done seen niggas go after a girl that they done heard a man talk about. That's nasty to me, too. Like, every.
How's that nasty?
You want to run in something that this next man and just ran, or your friend and hit and do all that? What? That's nasty to me. When?
What?
When?
What?
No, I'm saying, how is that nasty?
That's a grown ass man.
So how did all this shit? How did anything like you see movies, all that shit all the time? They always tell you like, why are you telling your friend this or this about your man? Your friend always be the one go double back on you and do that shit.
I mean,
you
that
come
ain't
to your house now, motherfucker, in there fucking and shit. And you can walk in your own crib and your girl getting your best friend getting fucked by your nigga.
See, that's some rat ass snake shit. But what I'm saying
definitely
is,
some rat ass. That's some definitely rat ass snake shit.
But men don't fall out over this. Like yes, I've watched
do. Niggas yes, do fall do. Out
niggas
for
niggas suckers.
But yeah. How do y'all be sitting back? Bro, niggas, so you mean tell me y'all gonna be knowing no niggas who be like, oh, they tell you about or told a nigga about a female and he
and then they be the
went right I'm behind you, her and y'all sit
secret.
Around and talk.
I'm gonna tell you a secret about niggas. Niggas are more emotional than women.
Boy, niggas, y'all used to run trains back in the day.
Suckers, for real, for real. Niggas is suckers out here, for real, for real.
People be okay like with stuff
y'all
and don't realize
it. Does he's smooth and he a player? I'm telling y'all, he really a sucker on the low. I'm trying to tell y'all. I cut a lot of niggas. I be around a lot of niggas. These niggas be suckers, man. For real.
I think what you trying to say, well.
I'm just saying, people be okay with shit and don't realize it.
Okay, so I think you trying to say you know how they be like, everybody fucking on everybody.
Right, yeah.
Like she just said, the nigga then fucked his nigga girl behind his back, or the girl then fucked her friend nigga or whatever. I feel like people, they want to regulate it how they want to regulate it. Like it's not the
no, that's
bitch.
Just me.
But when I put it, this way,
that's me fucking a nigga bitch. That's not the same as a polygamy relationship. Yeah.
I see. Y'all misunderstanding how I'm trying to explain it. I'm just basically saying, well, she kind of got it.
Out here anyway.
Y'all okay with a lot of shit. Y'all just don't be wanting to put titles on certain shit.
That's because
I've heard a million niggas be like, so what they got to do with me? You can't have friends, you can't have this, you can't have that. Like, y'all don't give a fuck that I'm laying up with this nigga.
I get what you saying, but you can't sit here and put that in.
I'm saying y'all be okay with a lot of stuff. Exactly, but they don't like the table.
Because I'm not in a relationship with this. I'm not trying to get in a relationship with
but
this
you
bitch.
Okay.
I'm trying to fuck. I'm not trying to get in a relationship with this bitch.
But you know that
a poly is a relationship. I'm not trying to get in. I'm trying to fuck this nigga bitch.
So that's listen. Niggas be okay, y'all. People be okay with a lot of shit.
That's
they just
true.
Don't put titles to it.
That's because
me putting
no
a title to
it.
Yes, it is.
No,
if
no,
you
not,
sit
bro.
Here, you okay?
That's all it is.
But you okay with me laying up with this nigga, fucking a raw dog and him, and you all? Oh, it don't matter to me. I just want
to
come.
I'm just
on.
Trying to fuck. Yes, I'm just trying to fuck.
You're
I don't
okay.
care about you having
like,
a nigga.
All, you know, like
that's his problem. That's something he got to deal with. I don't got to deal with you like that.
To 20 wives or whatever, it can't nobody touch none of them wives.
You don't need no candy, nigga.
Because I'm over here like,
no, I'm just
bro,
trying to.
Shit ain't the same,
you
bro.
Ain't let me explain
no,
it really.
Bro.
You don't
you
get what I'm saying.
It. No, you explain
y'all
it.
Be okay with shit without the titles, my nigga.
That's
you
because
gonna,
it don't apply to that.
Why you okay with
that's your fun,
exactly?
Man.
Maybe I should be quiet because they're not understanding what I'm trying to say. I'm just saying people be okay. It don't matter, maintain either way it
right.
go. People be okay with a lot of shit. They just don't like them titles.
That's because that doesn't apply to that though.
People, how many bitches you know be getting dogged the fuck out and she know this nigga cheating? But it's like, bitch, let him bring
yeah,
the hoe home.
Yeah,
you okay with it anyway? You don't
right,
want to do that, right?
Is anyway.
You gonna keep taking this nigga back over this? You why you want to just you know you ain't okay with
you
that?
Know, man,
it's an
okay,
ego
okay,
thing.
Okay, I get what you said, but as
but
he just
not
said,
a
that's
a
not
you know
that's
this.
Not a poly.
No,
a
I'm not saying
that's not gonna work.
I'm saying people be okay. All of it is falling in the same category. That's all I'm saying. People be okay. You if you know as a man that this girl got a man, she laid up raw dog and this man fucking on him.
You
said I just want to fuck.
All I'm trying to do is fuck.
It
don't
matter. You still okay with her fucking a whole nother nigga?
That's her nigga. I'm not trying to be her.
At the end of the day, all of that shit is the same with titles.
Okay. Cool, I will have a
problem. All that shit the same with titles. You be innocent on here. I like that. You know what I'm trying to get to, man.
He really just says real shit, though. Like,
exactly. That's
like,
real.
Damn,
not...
Like, shit. Like, damn.
I know
man,
niggas.
What's the accomplishment of fucking another nigga chick? Do y'all feel closer to the nigga?
Come on, fam.
You know what I mean? Niggas
but
be trying
you
to.
Gonna ask
no,
some stupid...
for real, though. That's what I be feeling like.
Look, what did I just say?
Y'all,
like
y'all, egos.
Some
y'all,
females
y'all
are men come
though.
To
y'all,
try to break up
we
people relationships
all
or whatever.
For us,
like
for
an
ego.
Like
nigga,
no,
us,
y'all
no,
be okay
no,
with a lot of
it,
shit.
No, it's not even that. It just be a
yes,
physical
it is.
Thing at the
it's just like, damn,
all
like,
I'm trying to do is fuck.
Oh, damn, but she fuck with dude.
But she fucking somebody else and you okay with that, right?
She not wanna be with her.
Just y'all putting titles on it again. I'm just asking a simple is answer that one question. She raw dogging and fucking the one nigga, and y'all okay with that, right?
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
Plain and simple. That's all I said. It don't matter. You trying to put a title. I'm just asking the question.
No,
you all right with that, right?
No, yeah. Yes, I am. Yes,
okay.
I am. Yes, I am.
Exactly. All that shit be the same
but
without the title.
Poly relationship with them, though.
I ain't say that. I'm
that's
just saying.
That's what you basically get
I'm
that,
saying.
Though.
All I'm saying is all that come shit be the same bro. Without titles, bro. Y'all be tripping. Maintain your ego in it, too.
No, I heard it. High skin. The innocent. He's talking about you.
Man.
I'm going to need y'all all to stop calling me light skinned.
You are light skinned.
She caramel. She ain't no light skinned.
It's like the fourth person today in this podcast.
Nigga, you lighter than
I'm
us.
Maintain you'll get it for
brown skin. Okay?
You beige.
Exactly, Muthang. Be nasty
and
anyway.
I'm not
nasty
innocent.
As fuck.
You beige.
I ain't beige.
You too.
She is caramel, bro. She brown. She caramel, rather. Look.
Brown skin, you know I love
you. Y'all, it's
so would y'all
as
do a poly relationship?
Yep.
I mean, I knew you.
That don't
I
count.
Knew your answer already.
That don't count. I'm talking about what we get some money and do our shit.
Okay, you.
What kind of fucking question is that?
It's a question, nigga.
I'm
answer.
Like, hell no. I can't. What?
Let's sit your dumb ass down.
Bro, why you keep throwing that in here, bro? I was just trying to make a point where people be okay with shit without titles. That's it.
Hey, did y'all see what they
said? Y'all keep talking. Y'all bitches probably was at my crib, too. So don't keep trying to say listen, about this little dirty hole y'all keep bringing up. Now.
Probably.
You know, don't act like that. Oh, I got to say this, too. Do you know how many niggas be weirdly trying to talk to me just because they know who I talk to?
That ain't weird.
That is weird. That is so strange. How is that not weird?
Go back.
You want to talk
ego thing? Like, oh yeah, I'm fucking this nigga booty bitch. That I'm telling you, it's an ego thing.
Nasty.
That's all it is.
Nasty.
Niggas have done that to my baby.
You
want?
You
want to
see what?
Mama, just because. That's my baby.
That's what I was finna say before. That's nasty, like, man. They just wanted to fuck on you because
of who you fuck with. Because who you fuck with.
I don't know. I be feeling like the nigga want to fuck the nigga or something.
Nah, exactly. So we coming from a woman point of view. That is weird as hell. Why do you want to deal with that woman because of another man? You like him, man.
On that level,
you like dude.
On that level, I don't know.
Coming from a woman.
It ain't no accomplishment. Like, yeah. You know what I'm saying? Like, it ain't no, like. My see, thing would be like
but niggas do be on that.
Yeah, that no, niggas be on that.
That's like, gay.
Like, my thing would be like damn, like I talked to her. I didn't know dude. I never seen dude. Right. You know,
that's different. That. I'm just saying.
But I'm saying like
he said niggas want to see why that chick is his main.
Right,
chick.
But look,
that's gay.
What, look,
it is. No, it is. But that's
look,
what
this
it
is. What I'm saying though, like if I never
like
seen you,
what
with
you
him,
choosing her for? Let me see what that's about.
Because you like dude, basically at the end of the day.
I'm saying though, like if I never seen you with dude, never. And then we already discussed, you know what I'm saying, had a conversation and shit, and then you finally come out like, oh, like, well, you know my baby daddy. Like,
well, that's different.
Late. It's not.
Yes, it is, because niggas purposely will try to talk to me because of who I talk to. Like, yeah, it's gay. Yeah, I'm like, I think you, no disrespect to my man, I'm just saying I think you like him. You kind of fan, you chasing after
like,
him. You using me to...
Your dick where he was sliding.
Where he was sliding his dick at. Like, that's nasty.
Like, do y'all want to bump dicks too?
No, you know what it be?
Who a lot of
smoke who? No, a lot of times.
Man, tell him, man.
What is he talking about?
He said
about?
We always making girls always
no,
trying to
a lot
make
of
some
things,
gay.
It be
who spells gay like that?
He probably didn't.
Oh, you don't want to get blocked.
So I now he like, okay. So that nigga locked up now. I can try to fuck him.
I understand that, but I'm saying I done had niggas purposely come to me and like try to talk to me and chant his name. Like, it'd be weird. Real. Like, bro, you like dude. You gay. Like, that's gay to me.
Yeah,
like, we grown
that's
as hell.
Definitely gay. Like, why is you coming to me talking about my nigga to me? Like, why
you
is
interested
you bringing him up?
Because of him. Bro. So if I ain't talk to him, you wouldn't be interested, right? You're gay. Simple. You like the nigga. Niggas be gay. Y'all, they be out here gay as hell. And I'm telling y'all, that's gay. And not just for me. I'm saying a woman in general. Like you want to go where he went? That's nasty.
But like you don't, do that too, though.
I'm sick of you
they
with
do.
This man. This reverse.
Not, we talking about why you dodging from the females?
I'm not.
Though.
I'm just saying.
You talking
do.
About saying that you looking
females
at me? Like, no, it
do
ain't.
It even
no,
worse.
It ain't. Oh my
no,
Lord.
Ain't no worse.
Yes, it is him.
Y'all gonna make me start putting people on blast on him.
We can.
Wait.
We really
y'all think y'all niggas these niggas be player and stuff? They don't.
I just said that. I
by a long
that.
Shot.
I just
we
said
never
that.
Said that. We said these niggas be suckers.
No,
over
I just
that
said.
Weird.
I just said these niggas ain't players.
Y'all, we in our last
30
seconds.
Oh, damn. Is we? Okay.
Shouldn't no nigga discuss no other man. Period. It ain't got to be me, her, whoever. It ain't got to be a specific person. I'm saying in general.
Like
that's gay.
The only nigga you fucked.
Okay, so where are we going with this? I'm 30. Why would he be the only nigga I had sex with in life, my nigga?
He said, I love
you trying to say like now or something? Because we can go there, maintain. Yeah, you need to come on here. Oh, I'm 30 years old. Why would he be the only person? Like that don't even make sense.
I mean, y'all want to bring him on the podcast?
We can have a messy day.
I want him to explain how he makes sense.
We can have a messy day.
He don't even make sense.
A lot of comments on this motherfucker.
Broke your virginity.
Yeah, I'm 30 motherfucking years old. Like, of course he not, my nigga. I'm just saying you niggas be weird for chasing after something another man got just to be.
Do that shit too.
I think you missing when I okay, they do that. But we speaking about that. The shit is
why
weird.
You, but why you just putting your own?
Because it's too weird as a man. Why are you mentioning another man?
She's a woman and she's speaking.
Yeah, but that's what I'm saying.
We gotta continue. Next week,
y'all. We gotta continue next week.
All right, y'all.
Part two of this segment.
Any topics y'all want to hear about inboxes?
We might bring
man. Get that growth oil and that lock and wax, you know.
And we out. Project, hey.